What's up, everybody? It's AJ with eTrailer.com. Today we're checking out this manual bilge pump from Seaflow. Now what this does is, in case of emergencies, helps you pump out that water that gets in your boat. Let's say there's electric failure and your normal bilge pump that's wired up on a switch or automatic didn't kick on because, like I said, there's an electrical problem. You're gonna have to do this manually and you can get it done quick. So this will help you pump out that water. And get it out of the boat. We got it set up on the table, kind of like how you'd set it up on your boat. We have a board clamp to the top of my table, and then we drilled in screws to keep the bilge pump attached to the board, because you're going to want to attach it to the boat, because if it's not attached anywhere and you're trying to use the lever, it's going to move all over. You want it to be nice and attached and out of the way, so that way, in case of that emergency, it's all set up, you can just quickly get to it, and this isn't going to be moving around on you at all. The other part of our setup is we ran the hose, this container, pretty much pretending that this is the bilge well on your boat, because that's where water is going to collect, and that's most likely where you're going to need to get that water out of. Another thing is that you can add another hose to this side that goes off the side of your boat, pumping the water out of your boat. We're just going to leave it on the end of our table today, just to quickly show you how it works. So I'm going to lift up on this handle here. You can see the rubber diaphragm lifts up and above the surface level, so it doesn't just get like this much water. It comes up here and fills this completely to push out more water and air. It actually operates very smoothly. I can do it with my thumb and finger, so it's not like it's hard to do. And every time it comes up and down, like I said, it's smooth. It doesn't feel like it's gonna get stuck anywhere. Nothing's gonna move out of place and cause it to misfire, which is good, because when you need this, you're gonna want it to work as quick as possible, and you're gonna be more likely to be going as fast as you can to get that water out. All right, we're gonna do a real quick test here. It says it can do 5.3 gallons in 1 minute. I don't know the equation to break that down, so we know the line in here is a gallon. I'm just gonna see how long it takes me to pump it out. The first couple pumps are gonna be starting to get the airflow, so those kind of don't count, but Aiden behind the camera is gonna time it. He's gonna tell us what the time is. You ready, Aiden?
Yep.
All right, say when.
And go.
I think we're done.
All right. That's about 28 seconds.
All right, 28 seconds. So it seems like I was a little off on the time. There's a lot of factors that contribute to that, not just me, but it's where the hose placement is. I had to tilt the bucket a little bit just to get that last bit of water in there. That's gonna happen in your boat. It's the, you know, gotta move the hose around a little bit just to get that last bit. But that being said, this hose is gonna fit in a lot of better places than a bucket would in your boat. You're trying to use a big old 5 gallon bucket to get that last bit of water out. It's gonna be a lot harder than having this hose just dropped in there and a couple pumps and it's gone. Speed aside, the main takeaway is it works. So when you need to use it, it's gonna be there and it's gonna help you out. You can always rely on the pump and the hose to get that water out of your boat. I think that does it for our look at the Seaflow manual bilge pump. I hope this helped.